गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, माय सेल्फ विनय त्रिपाठी, वेलकम टू योर ऑनलाइन क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू इन ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 10 ह्यूमन ऑक्यूपेशन। सी स्टूडेंट, प्रीवियस चैप्टर 9 वी हैव लर्न द एनर्जी रिसोर्स। आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन आफ्टर ऑब्जर्विंग द पिक्चर इन फिगर 10.1। सी स्टूडेंट, देर आर सो मेनी क्वेश्चन आर देयर, यू टू ऑब्जर्व द फिगर एंड राइट एंड गिव द आंसर। फर्स्ट, वॉट आर द काउ एंड बफलो इन पिक्चर ए डूइंग? सी द पिक्चर, हाउ द वॉट आर द काउ एंड बफलो आर दे आर डूइंग दैट। That means cow and buffalo are grazing in the pasture. That is land covered with grass and other low plants. We can say they are grazing the pastures. Can see the picture. Next one is, what is being obtained in picture B? See the picture. So what is obtained, student? That is milk is being obtained in picture B. Next one, what is happening at the milk collection centers in the picture C? See that. Milk is being filled for storage and sold at the milk collection center. See the picture. And next one is, in picture D, what is being transported? Where could the tanker be going? Let me see, students. Can you see the picture? That means what is milk is being transported to the milk processing centers. The tanker is on the truck. See the picture. And which product are seen in picture E? See the picture E. From what have this product have been made? Let me, students, see the picture E. In this curd, ghee, butter, cheese and shrikhands are the products seen in the picture E. And these products have been made from milk. Can you see that? All these products have been made from milk. And next one is, what else is happening in picture E? See the what else is happening that? See the in picture E, a person is testing the quality of the milk that is prepared milk product. They are testing the quality of the prepared milk product. Okay. And next one is, out of the products shown in picture F, which product do you use? See, students, there's a picture that F. That means I use all the products shown in figure F as milk product are high on nutrients and good for health. And because of that, I use all the products shown in picture F. Because all these are the milk products are there and milk products are high on nutrients and good for health. Okay. And see that what would be the main difference between milk and milk product? See, students, that milk is a beverage obtained from nature directly from different animals, while milk products are obtained by processing milk into milk products. So these are differences are there. Do this product perish quickly like milk? No, they have a longer life unlike milk. Okay. See, students, just go through explanation. All the above pictures are related to the rearing of domestic animals. See, students, all the above pictures are related to the rearing of domestic animals, obtaining milk from them, selling milk, processing milk at milk processing centers, making ghee, butter, cheese, shrikhand, paneer, milk powder, etc. from milk. That means all these products are made from milk only, selling them in the market, etc. This work is carried out at different level. And see, students, this work is carried out at different level. Man undertakes all these activities to satisfy his own needs. And man undertakes all these activities to satisfy his own needs. We classify these activities on the basis of their nature and the product they yields. Now look at the picture again and answer the following questions. See the student, there are so many questions are there, just go through that. First question, which of these activities is undertaken to obtain a product from nature? See, students, that is obtaining milk from the cow. Which product is obtained from it? That is milk product. How long does this product last? Let me see, students. If there will be a refrigerator, it will last for about 5 days to 1 week. That means if there will be a refrigerator, then it will last for about 5 days to 1 week. इन विच पिक्चर इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑप्टर फ्रॉम नेचर बीन कलेक्टेड? स्टूडेंट्स इन पिक्चर सी द प्रोडक्ट ऑप्टर फ्रॉम नेचर इज बीन कलेक्टेड इन ए पिक्चर सी. नेक्स्ट वन इज विच सर्विस डिड द मिल्क प्रोड्यूसर गेट थ्रू देयर दिस एक्टिविटीज दैट मीन्स ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड अनलोडिंग ऑफ मिल्क. ए टर्शियरी सर्विस इन द सर्विस विच द मिल्क प्रोड्यूसर रिसीव दैट मीन्स देर विल बी टर्शियरी सर्विस. नेक्स्ट वन इज वेयर इज मिल्क बींग टेकन वॉट हैपन्स टू द मिल्क देयर आफ्टर दैट मीन्स स्टूडेंट्स द मिल्क इज बींग टेकन टू द मिल्क प्रोसेस सेंटर्स फॉर प्रोसेसिंग मिल्क टू मेक मिल्क प्रोडक्ट. ओके वॉट मिल्क प्रोडक्ट आर सीन इन द पिक्चर? सी स्टूडेंट्स घी बटर चीज श्रीखंड ऑल दिस आर द प्रोडक्ट सीन इन द पिक्चर. नेक्स्ट वन हु इंस्पेक्ट दिस प्रोडक्ट्स? ए फूड इंस्पेक्टर दैट मीन्स ए पर्सन विथ स्पेशल स्किल्स एंड एक्सपर्टाइज इंस्पेक्ट दिस प्रोडक्ट. A food inspector. They inspect these products. Who have the person with his special skills and expertise inspects this product. Next one. What does the shopkeeper do with these products? What shopkeeper do student? The shopkeeper sell this product to the consumer. Simple. Next question. Which of these products are perishable and which are non-perishable? See students. All are the product even after proper storage will deteriorate and perish over a period of time. And next one is will the price and weight of this product be same as that of the milk? See students, the price and weight of this product will be higher after processing it. That means these products will be more durable and its quality too will be enhanced and so their price will be also higher. Okay. That means it is totally also, that means you have to discuss that, the teacher should have a detailed discussion about with this with students. See students, use your brain power. See students, all these questions, whatever we discuss that, it is we have to observe the picture, that means A, B, C, D, E, F. So through that, we are getting the answer, okay? Use your brain power. Milk is available at rupees 40 per liter. While dahi at rupees 60 per kg and paneer at rupees 200 per kg, if both are obtained from milk, why is there so much difference in their price? See students, milk is being processed obtained from nature, yes, and made it into different product. From that milk, different product will be made. These products are more durable. Their quality is enhanced and therefore their price is higher because their quality is it's enhanced and therefore its their price is higher. Okay. We carry out many activities to fulfill our needs. See students, we carry out different activities to fulfill our needs. We have many occupations, industries, trades, etc. Some of these activities are directly dependent on nature. And you know students, some of these activities are directly dependent on nature. It means that the products obtained in these activities are obtained directly from nature. Cows and buffaloes are animals and we domesticate them. See picture A. We see the picture A. We get milk from them. Therefore, this occupation is directly dependent on nature. And which occupation is directly dependent on nature? Such occupation, we can say it is a primary occupation. That means students, we get milk from them. Therefore, this occupation is directly dependent on nature. And such occupation which is dependent on nature are called primary occupation. Example, animal husbandry, fishing, etc. Some products obtained in primary occupations are used directly while others are used after making some changes in them. Dear students, now see picture E. See the picture E. Okay. So, see that in this picture, the milk is processed. You know, students, processing means what? Change or preserve something by a series of mechanical or chemical operation. We can say the processing. That means, in this picture, the milk is being processed after bringing it to the dairy. That is, the product obtained from nature is processed and made into different products. These products are more durable. Durable means what, students? withstanding, that means damage, withstanding damage because they are durable. And this way, their qualities has enhanced too, and therefore their price is also higher. For example, Srikhand, butter, cheese, and milk powder are processed from milk. This processing is an industrial activity. And see students, this processing is an industrial activity. Industries are based on raw material. More durable goods are produced in an industries. And you know students, more durable goods are produced in an industries. The raw material supplied to the industries is often obtained from nature. That means where it is obtained from nature. That means the raw material supplied to the industries is obtained. That means is often obtained from nature. That is from primary occupation. Occupation dependent on primary occupations are called secondary occupation. Occupation dependent on primary occupations are called secondary occupation. Example, food processing. Now look at picture C, D, and F. You will see milk collection and sale of milk, transport of milk and sale of milk products respectively. All these activities are related to the product of primary and secondary occupation. See students, so to see the look at the picture C, D, and F. So what we see that you will see the milk collection and sale of milk, transport of milk and sale of milk product respectively. All these activities are related to the product of primary and secondary occupation. Many a times this occupation provide complementary service to the other two occupations. Such occupation are called tertiary occupation. That means students, those occupation which provide complementary service to primary and secondary occupation are called tertiary occupation. Example, sale of goods. These occupations are complementary to all other occupations. These occupations are also called service occupation. These include transport of goods, loading and unloading of goods and sale of goods, etc. That means students, this includes transport of goods, loading and unloading of goods and sale of goods, etc. Now look at picture E. Here you can see a person testing the prepared milk product. This person is testing the quality of the product. To do this work, a person must have some special skills, and this is also a type of service. But this service is not an ordinary one. It requires special expertise, and therefore such service are called quaternary occupation. Tell me students, you have to look at the picture E. So what we can see that a person is testing the prepared milk product, and this person is testing the quality of the product. To do this work, a person must have some special skills, knowledge, and this is also a one type of service. But this service is not an ordinary one. For that, it requires special knowledge, skills, expertise, and therefore such service are called students quaternary occupation. So see students, this way I have to say that there are three types of, that means four types of occupations are there: primary occupation, secondary occupation, tertiary occupation, and quaternary occupation. Not all the services are directly related to primary or secondary occupation. For example, those of a driver, knife grinder, policeman, the postal service, etc. And see students, that means not all the services are directly related to primary or secondary occupation. Which are the examples are the student? That means those of a driver, knife grinder, policeman, and postal service, etc. Think a little, totally cancel. I have marked with pencil. No need to read this. Look at the picture in figure 10.2 carefully. We are learning the classification of occupation. See if you can answer the following questions related to sugar productions. See students, classify the occupation from primary to quaternary. There are so many questions are there. You have to discuss that. You have to solve that. Students, observe the figure 10.2. See that A, sugarcane field. B, place harvesting of sugarcane. C, place transport of sugarcane, how it was transported. एंड डी प्लेस सुगर कैन बीइंग कलेक्टेड एट द फैक्ट्री एंड ई प्लेस इंस्पेक्शन एंड मेंटेनेंस ऑफ मशीनरी इन द फैक्ट्री एंड एफ प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ सुगर कैन जूस जी प्लेस सुगर प्रोडक्शंस एंड क्वालिटी चेक एंड एच प्लेस सैक ऑफ सुगर बीइंग कैरिड एंड आई प्लेस सेल ऑफ शुगर. सो यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व दिस पिक्चर फिगर 10.2 एंड ऑन दैट बेस यू हैव टू गिव द आंसर. ओके, सी द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन हियर. विच रॉ मटेरियल इज यूज्ड इन द सेकेंडरी ऑक्यूपेशन. सो सी स्टूडेंट, विच आर द रॉ मटेरियल्स आर दैट इज सुगर कैन. ओके, नेक्स्ट वन, विच इज द फिनिश प्रोडक्ट ऑब्टेन इन द सेकेंडरी ऑक्यूपेशन. दैट मीन्स फ्रॉम सुगर कैन विच प्रोडक्ट इज फिनिश स्टूडेंट, दैट मीन्स शुगर इज द फिनिश प्रोडक्ट ऑब्टेन इन द सेकेंडरी ऑक्यूपेशन. नेक्स्ट वन, विच आर द सर्विस इन द टर्शरी ऑक्यूपेशन. सो दैट इज ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ सुगर कैन, सैक ऑफ सुगर बींग कैरिड एंड सेल ऑफ गुड्स. ऑल दिस सर्विस आर कम इन द टर्शरी ऑक्यूपेशन. विच पिक्चर इज रिलेटेड टू ए क्वॉटिनरी ऑक्यूपेशन. कैन यू नेम दैट ऑक्यूपेशन. सी स्टूडेंट्स, दैट मीन्स इन पिक्चर जी इज रिलेटेड टू ए क्वॉटिनरी ऑक्यूपेशन. विच वन? दैट इज जी वन. वाई? बिकॉज जी प्ले द सुगर प्रोडक्शन एंड क्वालिटी चेक एंड दैट्स वाई पिक्चर जी इज रिलेटेड टू ए क्वॉटिनरी ऑक्यूपेशन. द ऑक्यूपेशन इज क्वालिटी टेस्टिंग. ओके, एंड दिस वे सो यू टू ऑब्जर्व दिस 10.2 ऑन दैट बेस यू टू गिव द आंसर. ओके, ट्राई दिस एक्टिविटी. इट इज टोटली कैंसल. आई हैव मार्क इट पेंसिल. नो नीड टू रीड दिस. डू इट योर सेल्फ. सी स्टूडेंट, इज टोटली एक्टिविटी बेस. सो टू डू दिस बाय योर ओन वे. ओके, इट इज एक्टिविटी बेस. This is how to we classify the human occupation. Different occupations are practiced in different countries of the world. Through this occupation, economic transactions occur within a country and between various countries. This transaction decide the country's production of various goods and their annual income. This in turn is used to decide the extent of the country's development. And this way, students, that means we have classified the human occupation. And different occupations are practiced in different countries of the world. So through this occupation, economic transactions occur within a country and between various countries. And these transactions, that means these transactions decide the country's productions of various goods and their annual income. Okay, and this in turn is used to decide the extent of the country's development. See students, you have to observe Figure 10.3. This pie chart shows the percentage of manpower engaged in various occupations in the countries of Bangladesh, United Arab Emirates, that is UAE, and Turkey. Each pie chart shows the percentage of primary to tertiary occupation. Answer the following questions on the basis of the pie chart. See students, that means percentage of manpower engaged in various occupations, percentage shown here, and see that Bangladesh, United Arab Emirates, that is UAE, and Turkey. Figure 10.3, percentage of manpower engaged in various occupations in some countries. See friends, Bangladesh plays blue color shown for the primary occupation, brown color shown for secondary occupation, and green color shown for the tertiary occupation. And United Arab Emirates, that plays see that primary occupation, that is blue color, brown, that is secondary occupation, and green color, that is tertiary occupation. And Turkey place, see that blue color shown the primary occupation, brown, that is secondary occupation, and green, that is tertiary occupation. So you can see the pie chart. Okay, now see that there are questions are given here. Which country has more manpower engaged in primary occupation? So tell me that students, which country? See that Bangladesh. Okay, that means which country has more manpower engaged in the primary occupation? That is Bangladesh. Can you see that? Next one, which country has more manpower engaged in the secondary occupation? See friends, secondary occupation, that is Turkey. See that Turkey, that is brown color. Can you see that? Next one, which country has, that means which country has more manpower engaged in tertiary occupation students, that is United Arab Emirates, that is UAE. And next one is, which country has almost equal manpower engaged in all the occupation? So see, that is also Turkey. Let me see that, Turkey. Okay, understood. So this way you to observe this figure 10.3 and to give the answer. Okay, countries which have more manpower engaged in tertiary activities are considered to be developed countries. You know students, that means which country people are doing the more, that means manpower engaged in tertiary activities, we can say that country is developed countries, while countries which have more manpower engaged in primary activities are considered to be developing countries. Okay, that is India is still developing countries because people are engaged in primary occupation. Now rank the countries above from developed to developing. Okay, so this way you have to make that developed to develop. See students, so these are the pie chart are there from different three countries: Bangladesh, United Arab Emirates and Turkey. Okay, see students, exercise question number 1A, select the correct option. Question number B, give reason. So see students, all these are the assignment I am giving to you as your homework. You have to do this in your notebook and read this lesson twice, two times properly. I hope that you understood this lesson. Thank you.